Ladies and gentlemen, let's call it Storm.
In contrast to how it is when I rehearse after a long time, Paul Storm and I used to tour constantly together and sing together all the time. And at the last minute I said, hey, will you guys do these two songs? And they were like, yeah. And at the last minute we ran them and they were already perfect. So these guys, make everybody else look bad. Storm's even sick, for God's sake.
This better be good.
Yeah. No, now that I've set up expectations properly.
Yeah, I'm just gonna
be. Yeah, that's fine. this is about a dead dog in space.
So lift this all up from the.
It's about it. Okay, in reality, there was a dead dog in space. But in the song, no. In the song, maybe Laika is rescued by aliens. I mean, it doesn't say that in the song, but that's.
Aliens.
It could be what's happening.
Or maybe there's like four dead dogs in space.
I don't know. There's probably a lot of dead dogs floating around Earth right now. We don't even know. Anyway.
This is how these shows used to go, pretty much. I wonder why we stopped touring so much.
Oh, boy. Yeah, I know, but you know what? It's also an intonation problem, Jim. It's not just a tuning problem. Alright, try again. Okay, the guitar needs a setup. Alright, you want to come and do a setup with my guitar? Yeah, I didn't think so. I'm gonna play it out of tune just to spite Jimbo.
The cage is very small, a tiny silver ball that makes you a hero. Watching you, you're about to do, live on forever, even though you'll be dead and gone. Buckle up, we're about to turn the engines on. My star is burning too, I am receiving.
Now I'm falling free of the rules.
I love that song especially because I understand that it makes Tim Leo cry.
Ends up in the ICU. It's called the irony.
It's a great idea for a song.
How's that, Jim?
Just kidding.
Thank you.